In the previous part of this tutorial, we learned how to send objects in a scene from Maya to Softimage and back again to leverage the strengths of each software. We ended up with a scene in Maya with the correct behavior. In this part, we will tweak the particle system's per particle attributes to achieve a render that looks much more like fire. First, we need to change the particles to a more appropriate type. Select the particles and open the attribute editor. In the shading section, set the particle render type to cloud. Now we will add a particle volume shader, as this is a similar shader type to the one used by Softimage. Select the particles and open the hypershade. Right-click the particle clouds node and then assign the material to the selection. Add a particle sampler node and multiply divide node to the graph. The fire particles in Softimage are shaded based on their age percentage. To reproduce this in Maya, we'll retrieve each particle's age and lifespan to calculate that value. Connect the age attribute from the particle sampler node to the input 1x of the multiply divide node, and then lifespan pp to input 2x. Set the operation attribute of the multiply divide node to divide. The output value of this operation will be used to drive all shading attributes. Now add a remap value node to the graph. Connect output x from the multiply divide node into the input value of the new remap node. Select the remap node and rename it to remap color. Now set the color gradient so that it changes from bright white to dark gray. Connect the out color of the remap color node into the color and incandescence input of the particle cloud node. This will allow us to remap our cached color values. Now add another remap value node to the graph and connect output x from the multiply divide node to the new remap node's input value. Select the remap node and rename it remap transparency. This time we'll set the value ramp so that the particles start opaque and fade out as they burn. Connect out value to the transparency RGB inputs of the particle cloud node. This will allow us to remap our cache transparency values. We will need to repeat this process for the particle density, but you can also do the same for many other attributes to tweak the fire aesthetic as you desire. The shading network in Maya is unaffected by further exports and imports to and from Softimage. For example, we can modify Johnny's jump at the end of the animation, as well as the cube to match that animation. We can recache this tweak and update the Softimage scene. Now if we send the updated Softimage simulation back, you can see that the material settings maintain the changes we made in Maya.